bro. No. How could you overlook Taylor Swift? How could you overlook Taylor Swift, man? Open your eyes. Hello my wonderful royals and welcome to my YouTube channel Brit K-Pop Reacts, and today marks the beginning of a wonderful journey that I am very, very excited to go on. And the journey does concern the lovely Miss Taylor Swift, and I am a self-confessed Swiftie and have been for a long while now. You may well have seen my previous Taylor Swift reactions. I did react to both the Folklore and Evermore full albums when they dropped, and the music videos that went with them, Cardigan and Willow. So I have done all of those. If you've not seen them already, please do check them out. If you have, awesome, you'll know who I am. But I am very much a Swiftie. I have loved Taylor Swift. I got into Taylor back in the 1989 era was when I first really sort of fell in love with her. However, I don't know everything, and this is where this journey comes in. My plan with this journey is, as you may be able to tell from the title, to cover every single Taylor Swift music video in order. And the reason I want to do that is because I want to be able to call myself a proper Swiftie. You know, I want to be able to call myself a full Swiftie, if you will. I want to go full Swiftie. And as I say, there is a lot I don't know. Before K-pop came along, I didn't really watch music videos. Music videos were something I didn't really do, to be honest. Obviously, since I've got into K-pop, I now react to the MVs all the time. I react to the music videos all the time, so I'm used to that. But music videos as a thing wasn't really something I really bothered with. So a lot of the Taylor Swift music videos I have not seen. Obviously, there are some I have seen, but a lot of them I haven't seen. So I thought this would be a great way of going back and seeing all those music videos that I've missed out on over the years. And also some of the songs, because honestly, looking through her sort of videography of the music videos she's done, I haven't listened to all the songs. I haven't, especially some of the early stuff. So I really want to go back, go through everything. But that is the plan with this journey. I am hugely excited to embark upon it, and I hope you guys are too. Please do join me in this journey. Get involved in the comments, guys. I want to talk to you a lot. I've said it before, Swifties, the Swiftie fandom is one of the best fandoms I've interacted with, honestly. I cannot stress how just lovely you all are. Genuinely, in the comments and stuff of my previous album reactions, you were all absolutely brilliant, and it made me want to do Taylor more. Obviously, I love Taylor anyway, but it made me want to do Taylor more because you guys were so fantastic, honestly, in the comments. So I do want to interact with you lot. That would be absolutely awesome. I do have a Discord server now. It's in the link. There is a link in the description below to that. So please join that as well. It'd be great to see you on there. There is a channel I've set out for Swifties, for Taylor Swift fans. So please get on there, and you can interact with me on there. You can interact with anyone else that joins on there. There are plenty of other people on there through K-pop and all that jazz, but I am hoping to build a bit of a Swiftie fan base on there as well. So please do join that Discord. It'd be awesome to, as I say, just interact with you guys. I want to go full Swiftie, and I'm sure there's some of you full Swifties out there. So if you are out there, get in those comments, get on my Discord, and let me know about all this lovely stuff. But with all that being said, guys, there is nothing left to do but to begin this journey. Let's do this. So as you likely already know, coming into this video, we are starting with the first two MVs that Taylor Swift ever did. And the first one is Tim McGraw, which I don't think I've heard, to be honest. I don't think I've heard this song. Teardrops on My Guitar I have heard at some point, not for a while. Tim McGraw, I don't think I've heard this song, honestly. Tim McGraw is a country singer, isn't he? I'm sure I'm right in thinking that. Isn't he the guy that did a cover with Nelly at some point? Like Over and Over, I think it was called. I really like that song. He did do that, didn't he? Tim McGraw and Nelly did Over and Over. Let me know if you know, but I'm pretty sure he's a dude, right? He's a country singer. And I'm just gonna press play on this. I'm ready. Let's do it, Taylor. Begin. This is exciting. I'm genuinely excited.
Truck that had a tendency of getting stuck.
ones. Just that voice, man, that voice. I will never ever get over that voice. Taylor Swift's voice is a phenomenon. It really is. I just love it so much. The sound of it and everything. You can completely understand why when she came on the scene, the country music scene and everything, through her beginnings, she took it by storm, because just that voice, it sounds so good. It sounds so relatable. And that's what's brilliant about Taylor Swift. She's so relatable. And it really comes across even with this early stuff. And obviously country music, I think, I'm not particularly a huge fan. My brother is, incidentally. But I understand it to be quite, it is very relatable, isn't it? That's kind of the whole thing with country music. Taylor's voice fits perfectly in that mould. If I'm correct, she's 17 here. No, 16, I think, at this point. When this song was released, I believe. I did look into it. Her birthday is actually 2 days before mine, the 13th of December. And this came out around June of that year, I believe. Was it 2006, I think it was? It's just so cool to look back on all this. It really is. It's just lovely, isn't it? Absolutely adore it. Dress. Awesome. I love the fact she got like the accent a bit more. Something about Taylor Swift with a guitar, man. Oh, it just makes me happy. It really does. Oh, mate. Because the lyrics are talking about Tim McGraw, so it sounds like he's a singer, isn't he? I know he is. It's just supposed to mess with my brain now, because I saw the name and I thought, I know that name. It makes sense, though, based on the lyrics she's singing. Like, when you think Tim McGraw, you think of my favourite song and all that. It makes sense. So I'm going with it. Is he involved in this song at all? I'm not actually sure about that. Wouldn't think so, but I don't know, maybe it's. It's just so gorgeous, it really is. That's the point, while we're at it, talking about Taylor and country music, I was also very annoyed to find out about this whole, like, them taking Taylor Swift off of that country, like, music wall thing. I'm not entirely sure the whole story behind it, but she was on, like, a wall, like, sort of, like a hall of fame almost, like a wall of fame type thing, with loads of, like, country music stars, and she was taken off it. I'm assuming because she's all mainstream now and stuff. That pissed me off. It's like, no, look at where she began. Look at what she did in the country music world back in the day. Watch back over this stuff and you tell me she doesn't belong on that wall. So yeah, that pissed me off. But anyway, detour. It sounds amazing, though. Her voice is perfect. It is. It just is. I love the accent she's got here. Taylor! She makes me so happy. She really does. Look at her eyes. Her eyes. It's a catchy song, isn't it? It gets in your head a little bit. This is going to be going on my head for a while, I think. It's just stunning. I kind of want Taylor to do a country, like a combat country album. I kind of want that. You know, it's like seeing this like early stuff. I just like Taylor Swift with the guitar just like strumming at it and this sort of country business. Like, I feel like we need that in our lives, you know, at some point for like a, you know, a 12th, 13th album, whatever. Just drop a cheeky little country comebacks album. I'd appreciate that. This MV is really sweet as well, the music video. You said the way my blue eyes shine, but those Georgia stars to shame at night. I said that's a lie. She's incredible. She's incredible. Look at her. Oh. The whole music video was gorgeous. It was cute. It was lovely. The song was as well. What the fuck are you? What the hell is this? Dolmio? What? Ah. What makes you think, after watching a Taylor Swift video, my mind is in any way on sauce? Sauce for like pasta and shit. I'm not in any way thinking about that right now, Dolmio. You can fuck off. Right now. I've got better things to think about. Thank you very much. Oh, Taylor. I can completely understand why she exploded on the scene the way she did. And I know as well that this, based on sort of reading up and refreshing my memory on her history, as it were, I know that she was around for a while before this. So this was like sort of, I guess, her big break in a way in the country world. And obviously this was the first music video and all that. But I know she was around a while before that. Like, she's been doing this since she was very young, right? I believe 10 or something like that. I don't know, maybe even younger, I'm not sure. But she's been knocking around for a while in terms of in the, you know, the music scene, as it were, the music world. But you can absolutely understand why she made a splash when she did arrive. Just based on this, you can see it. She's pretty, she's relatable, she's got a fantastic voice. Like, it's just like the complete package, just in one little beautiful song and music video, and I absolutely love it. Now we are going to move on to Teardrops on My Guitar. So this is Taylor Swift with Teardrops on My Guitar, and I know this one made a huge splash when this one came out. I think this one was even bigger, wasn't it? I don't know if this got a lot of attention outside of country. I feel like it might have done, possibly. I don't know. When I think of this song, I think of it being quite a big song for Taylor in terms of, I'm not saying that it, you know, it was huge in general music or anything, but I think it did. It was noticed, I'm pretty sure. I did also, in between cuts, I looked up Taylor because I wanted to find out about that accent, and because apparently she's from Pennsylvania, but she relocated to Tennessee. So I don't know if that's, because that's what I was thinking, is that like a sort of Tennessee style accent? I'm not sure that she's got within these songs. I don't know if that's slightly put on, if she's not originally from there. I'm not sure. To be honest, I don't know accents very well, especially American accents. You might have to let me know, all of you Americans, what kind of accent that is that she's got and how kind of natural it is, because I'm intrigued by it. Let's go. Teardrops on My Guitar. Wait, hang on. I need to follow this shit. I know that guy.
Hey, are you gonna go to the game on Friday?
Well, I was thinking about it. Why?
Bro, I don't know. Just asking.
Is he in stuff?
Oh, I met this girl. I gotta tell you about it later.
I swear I recognize him. Oh no, but she wants it to be her. She wants to be the girl, mate. Pay attention. Jesus, man. Look at her with the face bits. I don't know what they're called. The little things on her face. I'm going to call them face bits, and that's that. But I don't know if that's what they're actually called. I don't know what they're called. Oh dear, look at that dress. The voice. To me, Oh, it's stunning, isn't it? Stunning. That shot, right? That shot, she looks like some sort of flipping, you know, exotic mermaid. You know, if you took like the, you know, like the strap off the dress and it was just like, she'd almost look like a fucking mermaid. I don't, maybe that's just me. Maybe that's just me. I just feel like she looks a bit mermaid-esque in that shot. Anyway, shut up. Let's just carry on playing. It's embarrassing myself. Oh, dear. No, she does. You can't even see her feet. Melts my heart. I tell you what, Taylor Swift in goggles is a look, like science goggles. That's a look. She needs to bring that one back. I quite enjoy that. I think it works. Taylor, you've got something going there. I'm feeling a fashion trend coming on. Just saying. You don't have to give me any credit, don't worry. If you're watching, by any chance, Taylor, you know, you can have that one on me. Don't worry about it. I'll pretend it's your idea, because technically it was. I don't expect any credit. You can if you want. Look at that. I don't know what's wrong with me. My brain, she's melting my brain. Oh, no. Look at the voice. I got the way she says, sings words. It is. Me, and I know it's probably going to turn out well in the end, but you know what, at the moment it's annoying me. How could you overlook Taylor Swift? How could you overlook Taylor Swift, man? Open your eyes. Fuck. Annoys me. It annoys me. Oh, she's just, that ability is really coming through with this, like that ability to, and I talked about this on my Evermore reaction, the ability Taylor's got to, like, just the way she sings words, the way she makes words sound when she sings them. She puts emphasis on words and she sings words in a way that's just perfect. It's just like she sings every word the way it's supposed to be sung. And even here, you can kind of hear that in the way she sings certain words and things. And I don't know if that's maybe a country music thing, maybe like because of the relatability factor, they focus a lot on that. On kind of emphasizing words and the way that you sing to really get the message across and the emotions across and things. And maybe that's something they kind of teach within the country music world. I don't know. I'm just guessing, maybe. But even here, you can kind of hear it in Taylor's voice and the way that she is so relatable, which I think is a big reason as to why she exploded the way she did, is because she is so fucking relatable in the way that she sings and the way she puts music across. And even here, you can tell it's just incredible at this young age. I know, right, Taylor? I'm pissed off as well, mate. I'm with you. It's not fair, is it? She's not good enough for him, but you are, Taylor. You know what, Taylor? Forget about him. Move on. Find someone else. Plenty of fish in the sea. He's probably a dick anyway. Don't worry about him. Don't cry, Taylor. Oh. I should have known it wouldn't have a happy ending. It's fucking, it's country music, isn't it? It never has a happy ending. That's the rule. Fuck's sake. So I mean, she makes you feel it. She makes you feel it within. She puts these music videos on where she's getting all emotional over a dude, and then the way she sings about it, just it just enters your heart and you feel it. You feel like you are Taylor in that moment. You feel like you're feeling everything she's feeling. It's powerful. That's what I mean about Taylor. She has that ability. I never thought I'd ever feel like a girl in high school pining over a guy who's got another lady and doesn't want me. But right then I felt it. I felt that feeling. Just incredible. Unfortunately, Taylor Swift has found her guy now and is happy, and that's what matters. Again, just such a gorgeous song, and I'm not generally that huge, bigger fan of slow songs. I've said it before, like, slow songs aren't really my thing. But when Taylor does them, they just stick with me. They really do. They stick with me because, again, because that relatability factor, the way she sings it, you know, particularly coming through from a country music world, I can completely understand why she made the splash that she did, why she made the impact that she did within that world, because from what I gather, that's what that world's all about, at least partially, is making you feel those songs, especially these kind of songs when they're about breakups and you know, unrequited love or whatever the hell else it might be. Those kind of songs that have to have that emotional impact. She's so good at that. She's so good at that. And both these songs just told such beautiful stories, and she tells those stories so well. I just love her for that. I love her for that. With all that being said, guys, we'll leave it there. This has been the first episode, if you will, of my Taylor Swift journey. As I say, I'm planning to do every single Taylor Swift music video in order. So please stick around for the rest. Now, I will be doing these once a week, hopefully. That is the initial plan. I'm thinking of even making it like a Taylor Tuesday, possibly, because I'm planning this to come out on Tuesday, so I might make it a thing, but we'll see what happens. But I do, of course, plan to continue these naturally because it is a journey. So please join me on that journey. Drop us a like, drop us a comment, and of course, subscribe if you enjoy this, guys. And as I say, please join me on my Discord server in the link below if you're interested. And continue to follow me on my journey. But with that being said, I'll see you next time, guys. Selengay. I love you all.